Hi, I'm Bill Stackpole. I'm a professor in the Department of Computing Security in the Golisano College of Computing and Information Sciences. The Golisano College is got five different departments in it. That is software engineering, information science and technology, interactive games and media, computing security, and computer science. Golisano College is a group of like-minded individuals. We are computing people. Some of us like to code. Some of us like to break things. Some of us like to fix things. Other people like to interact with objects and ideas and systems to try and make everybody's life a better place.
One of the opportunities for GCCIS is to enter through something called computing exploration. You may not know exactly what you want to do, and the computing exploration program covers most of the college programs where you come in, you do well, you get a smattering of pretty much everything, not quite everything, but most of the stuff, and then you get to choose.
The opportunities in computing in general are significant. They're interesting jobs in interesting places, and you are almost guaranteed to get employment doing something that you think is interesting.
I think the computing field is really cool because of how broad it is. You can really take your knowledge and apply it to anywhere that you want to be. There's a bunch of opportunities when you come out, and I think RIT is really the best place for that because we do have that co-op experience and professors are keeping up to date with what's going on out in the real world as well as what's going on academically.
GCCIS is unique. We do a number of different things. We have competitions and events for students on a regular basis. We have WIC hacks on campus, specifically focused on women in computing. We have the CPTC, the Collegiate Penetration Testing Competition. That's an international event that draws people from around the world to RIT. We have a CCDC team, the Collegiate Cyber Defense Competition team. RITSEC, the RIT Security Club, and they run ISTS, the Information Security Talent Search, that's completely student-run.
The team of six that I've been working with have been lucky enough to be funded by Magic Spell Studio, who's an incubator here on campus. And that's how I got started with the project that I'm working on now, called Icarus. Icarus is a multiplayer action-adventure game about a young woman who's exploring through elemental biomes and engaging in immersive combat.
Students do interesting research. They are working with myself and some other faculty and other departments on how to build visualizations for security, on how to make learning security tools fun and interesting, either through gamification of those tools or by figuring out new ways to approach old problems.
We have the esports group that we're looking at ways to think about how students compete at games and then look at the world of cybersecurity. And the way students learn computing security is through competing, playing. We can have students in games and students in computing security work together to figure out what that means to learn, what it means to teach the world what security is, what is a password, how do you protect it, and make games out of that. So sometimes parents and students ask, so game design development, the undergraduate degree, what does that mean? What is it that I'll actually be doing? I like to tell students that you'll be getting a core computing education within the context of computing with media. So what does that mean? Think tic-tac-toe. Someone had to think of that game. Someone had to think of the rules. Someone had to think of how it's constructed. Someone had to maybe think of the lines. How do you play it? How do you win it? How do you not win it? That's game design. Game development is, now let's go ahead and make this. We need to draw this, we need to display it, we need to program it. So we focus in on the design, the rules, the systems, and we focus in on the computing. Not only can students learn about games in game design development within the computing college, but they can work with others in the College of Art and Design, in the College of Liberal Arts, and see how all these programs, all these students are all collaborating and they're connecting with each other for entrepreneurial portfolio development all through the Magic Center. We want to make sure though that you have the computing. So if you don't want a job in the game industry, or if you can't get a job in the game industry, you can get a job in many kinds of industries.
I'd say RIT is better than other schools because we have our co-op experience, so you're getting paid money from whatever company you're working for and getting experience that you can walk out the door after graduation and really have that true experience on your resume. I've had two co-ops here at RIT. My first one was with Par Government and my second one was with Red Argyle. They've really given me a lot of different opportunities to learn, so I get a lot of different hands-on experience, as well as I've had client-facing experience, so talking to clients directly, getting their feedback.
Having the opportunity to get real-world work experience is a huge advantage over other universities and students. My first co-op was in a medical company at my hometown. I was doing project coordination and back-end development for them. My second co-op was in Los Angeles at 20th Century Fox. There, I was doing graphics development and tools development, working on their James Cameron Avatar game. My most recent co-op, and what I'll be doing full-time, is at Unity Technologies.
Our students go out there and co-op, and they learn from these industries and bring the stuff back before they graduate. This is what makes RIT unique, especially within computing. Our students are tackling all of the world's problems with all that they're learning. Computer science, the field of computing, the fields of information science, and all of these degrees we have within the College of Computing and Information Sciences tackle all of that data, tackle all of the intricacies, how we think about thinking about problems. That's where this gets solved. And we're looking at deeper and deeper issues all throughout the world. And because RIT has such a comprehensive collection of faculty, academic programs, industry contacts, has a long history, is one of the largest computing colleges in the world, we are poised to continue to solve these world's problems.
Deciding to come to RIT is a great thing. Make sure you try out new different things. There's plenty of opportunities to do that at RIT.
Don't be afraid to share your passions. Many people love to feed off the passion and cool projects that you work on. As well, it's important to get your name out there and show them cool things that you're developing. Stay humble, stay hungry, and stay passionate.
I meet new students every year. I appreciate the insight, the enthusiasm, and the new ideas that you bring to RIT. And I look forward to meeting you this fall.
We're very excited that you're giving the chance to look over this material. Let us know if you have any questions. I hope to see you someday in our classes. And welcome to RIT.